Let's be honest, if you ask people who their favorite Avenger is, I'm pretty sure Wanda and Vision aren't going to be most people's top picks. But now that Marvel Studios is branching out more into television, their series are able to give previously supporting characters a bigger opportunity to shine. Last weekend, we got our first taste of MCU TV with the first two episodes of WandaVision. And personally, I enjoyed them. I love the 50s sitcom-style storytelling, the vintage commercial segments, and the general visual style that it's going for. The detail put into this is really respectable. I especially like the more unsettling scenes that give us a glimpse into the horror that may be going on in this seemingly normal world, like when Vision's boss started choking or when the radio started talking to Wanda. Kinda reminds me of something out of the Twilight Zone. In general, the show's uniqueness compared to other Marvel projects is exactly what I wanted to see out of these Disney Plus series. Honestly, I'm surprised they didn't release one of their more conventional looking shows first, like Falcon and Winter Soldier, to more easily get people on board the Marvel Disney Plus train. It reminds me of when Marvel had to deal with Netflix to make those Defenders shows. It made sense that they released Daredevil first in that case, since his story was a lot more standard superhero than the other Defenders. However, Marvel has grown a lot since that time, so I'm sure they're fine with taking bigger creative risks nowadays. They know that fans of the MCU will most likely be on board for any content they make because of the insane connectedness of all these characters and properties. And that brings me to one of the biggest complaints about WandaVision's debut. A lot of people have been talking about the fact that the first two episodes don't really tell us much about what we can expect from the main storyline that season one is trying to tell. And even though I enjoyed the first two episodes, I will admit that most of my enjoyment does come from their style over substance. If this show wasn't connected to the MCU at all, its first episode especially doesn't do much to reel in new potential audiences who aren't big fans of the movies. When creating the first season of a show, I feel like it's really important to craft a good standalone pilot, something memorable that will keep people engaged for future episodes. If you've seen Breaking Bad, you know how thrilling that pilot was. Vince Gilligan, the show's creator, even said that he made the first episode in a way that would grab the attention of first-time viewers. WandaVision, though, doesn't really do that. In fact, I think the second episode could have been the pilot, if I'm being honest. The second episode had more interesting scenes, further developed the world by introducing new characters, and had a much more memorable ending cliffhanger with that dude in the beekeeper suit. So yeah, at this point there's not much to go off of right now in terms of judging the quality of the show. As a Marvel fan, I'm obviously intrigued to see how this season is gonna go, and how it's gonna connect to Doctor Strange 2 and Spider-Man 3, but for now, I can't really recommend this show to anyone, especially to non-Marvel fans. At least from what we can tell right now, WandaVision seems like a show that's willing to take its time to uncover its actual plot. So it may be better for people who are skeptical about these new Marvel series to binge watch it when all the episodes are available. But for us week-to-week viewers, let's hope that the next few episodes move the plot at a much faster pace, because I'm sure we're all interested in seeing the full potential of this show. Thanks for watching, like and subscribe, and feel free to comment down below what your thoughts are on WandaVision thus far.